Hey, Shalom, Shalom.
Shalom.
Let's all start off by giving all praises to Yahweh.
Bashem, Yahushai, Bashem, Kakodash.
Double honors unto the elders and apostles of great news to salutation to the Akim pushing this word in sincerity and sincerity and sincerity and truth. Shalom unto all you Akkots out there listening and learning. This is your brother Yasad.
Brother Yahardan.
From the JMS Prophetic Vibration Camp Trinidad, bringing unto you another lesson, willing to edify into the spirit here. You know, so this lesson will be considering give diligence to make your calling of election sure. Because, hey, we see now is the time that this devil coming down with his wrath, with his agenda, but we might ought to be on Yahweh Shemeshai right now. We might ought to be on keeping the Lord, keeping sturdy and stiff, and enduring as a hard soul here for Yahweh Shemeshai, because we know only He could deliver we out of these perilous times to come. So yeah, I'll start off with this whole scripture in 2 Peter 1 and 10. It says, wherefore the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure, for if ye do these things, ye shall never fail. So if we do, if we take instruction from the Lord, we wouldn't fail. We wouldn't, you know, we would be taken care of. So I'll just bring all this next piece of here in second.
Yeah, and too, what the better was saying, I know too. We can't be on in this worldly, carnally minded, like some of these tutor jigs and them, right? We have to study. We have to study Yahweh Shemeshai and the laws of statutes and commandments that He set forth for we in this time. And we can't be shaky in the times to come. Because if we shaky now, we're gonna happen to the in times to come. Men gonna fall off and fall out of the shoot.
Can't. This book of 2 Thessalonians chapter 2 and from verse 14. It says, whereunto He called you by our gospel, right, to the obtaining of the glory of the Lord Yahweh Shai. Right, so we all are, we was called unto this gospel through the prophets of the Lord from the apostles on down. It said, therefore, brethren, steadfast and hold the traditions which ye have been taught,
can
whereby word or our epistle. You want to break it?
Yeah, the word and the epistle, you understand? That the word I have about Hashem Yahushai, right? We had to continue doing the works, continue doing about Hashem Yahushai, tell me to do. Yeah, that is righteousness. That is righteousness. I just want to bring all this quick piece up here. Concerning to the brother was seeing earlier and all too. We had to focus on Yahweh Shemeshai, focus on anything we tell we to do. Yeah, this is Colossians chapter 3 and verse 1. It says, if ye then be risen with Yahweh Shemeshai, seek those things which are above. Right? We are to seek the kingdom of heaven. Right? Seek righteousness. It says, where Yahweh Shemeshai sitteth on the right hand of Yahweh. It says, set your affection.
Hold on there.
Yes, right.
It says, if ye be risen with Yahweh Shai,
can.
And hey, we was in that darkness, just as going back to that dark bones, that dry bones in the valley, you know. So when we get this truth, we eyes get enlightened.
Correct.
We eyes get opened up. We start to put back on our flesh, upon we dead body, and we being risen. We risen back with the knowledge of Yahawashai. Risen back with the knowledge of Yahawashai. Coming back onto our heritage, right?
Yahawashai living one or two. Like this word is what is spirit and it's truth. This word is life. You understand? So when we get the better life, right, we'll go back for down to the beginning and all too. Right? When you get the better life, we get enlightened, as the brother say. You will shine your eyes, be back up from the dead.
Yeah, go ahead now.
Yeah, it says, verse 2, it says, set your affection on things above, not on things on this earth. Right? So, that go back to, watch niggas in the world. Them like a dog going back to the freaking vomit. Then going back to the wicked ways. You can't go back to the wicked ways in this time, and you had to stick. As I know, me and brother, big brother was talking, hold on too.
but I ain't too sure what he picks up, right? But when you know coming to the truth, you gotta be fiery from how you know coming to the truth to the end. You can't, it's not semi long. Right? It's not semi long. You wish I do like, you I don't like no lukewarm or no cool. You gotta be hot.
That is it, man.
Yes, it is.
Here, I have a precept to add concern, and you know, you have to seek the things that are above. Matthew chapter 6 and verse 19. It says, lay not up for yourself treasures upon earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. Yeah, hey, even within the system, the little hard earned money you work for, the bank stacks you off of it. So there's always something to hinder you. Even sometimes you might have something in this life, somebody looking to thief it, to rob you of your goods. But the scripture says we not to lay up treasures upon earth. But verse 20, but lay up yourself treasures in heaven.
Come.
And by we laying up that is we presenting ourselves acceptable unto the Lord. You know, whereby we could be glorified just as Yahweh Shai and endure unto the end. It says, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. So if we mind is to gain something in the system, what are we going to end up having to do? We gotta bow to the system and take that so-called cure. We going and had to, you know, do after according to the wicked and sin. Take that cutting in our flesh. If we treasure and we heart based upon the earth. But if your heart and your treasure is up in heaven, we will listen to Yahweh Shem Yeshai. As the scripture say, we ought to obey Yahweh Shem Yeshai rather than man.
Come.
I'm going to go back to the 2 Thessalonians 2 and from verse. So, from verse 16. It says, now our Lord Yahweh Shai himself and Yahweh, even our Father, which had loved us and had given us everlasting consolation and good hope through grace, this comfort your heart and establish you in good word and work. So through the word we ought to comfort ourselves, and by we taking diligence, we seeking diligence in this truth is by we presenting good work before the Lord.
Correct.
You know, doing what the Lord tell us to do. Go out and preach the word. We are a pilgrim. We are, you know,
soldier for about
Can
because when you go back into the army, right, is order. You understand? It's order. It's nobody not breaking or wrong. You understand?
Can.
So we are to stand from as a soldier, because this truth here, right? This truth is the army here. You understand? When we come into the truth, we join the Yahweh Shem Yahshai army here. So when in this army here, we have to obey orders, right? Obey Yahweh Shem Yahshai, because he's the top G.
Yeah. The scripture in 1 Peter chapter 1 and 13. The scripture says, wherefore, good of the loins of your mind, be sober. By we gooden up the loins of our minds, as we steadfast in praying and fasting, we eat in this book, just as the angel said unto John.
Come.
You know, eat of this book, that it may be bitter in thy belly and sweet in thy mouth. So thy we keeping that meditation with our mind with the Heavenly Father, continue reciting the scriptures. We ought to make this a part of our life now.
Correct.
Because this is our heritage. We is the chosen children of Israel to keep the Lord's law. To keep the Lord's law.
Correct.
And then, as the scripture say, we departed from that. Now is the time that we gain back the Lord. We ought to seek him 10 times more.
Correct.
So when we seek in the Lord 10 times more, is we going to be pushing the work more to continue carrying out the word. You know, making yourself an example unto these two goods. So actually, when your family, all those amongst you, see you, they will say, well, yeah, this is a wise and understanding person.
Correct, mm. Because what's when in the world, the amount of length is good to do certain things when you're in the world. Right? Like certain times carnival come, whatever time come in the world, you doing all kind of things just to get wherever you have to get. Right? So this truth here, you know, we have to put this truth in front of everything. This is the most important, Yabashim Yashai is the most important thing. Right? But we seeking we salvation and all too, with fear and trembling. Ah. So we have to you know, is put this first. Put Yabashim Yashai first. Because the amount of things that we, but first that we learn all too. What's down to me for me for example, right? What's for me for example when I was in Christianity, the amount of things that I would do for the church, right? It had to be 10 times. It had to be, I used to be doing 10 times more for the brotherhood, 10 times more for the word of Yabashim Yashai.
It said, "Be sober and hope to the end for the grace that is to be brought unto you at the revelation of Yahweh Shai." Yeah, so we being sober. We being sober as meaning continue staying in prophecy. Correct. Taking heed of the news and watching what's going on. And hey, when we actually being that, we being in the spirit. Correct. Again, the understanding of what actually taking place. What in the time of the prophecies we actually what prophecies actually being fulfilled at the moment.
Yeah.
But right now we see the concerning the so-called cure cards, you know, the immunization cards actually looking to crack down on fraud concerning the immunization cards. Once you be found, you could be given 7 years. Hmm. So they're trying to put measure in place that you can't boycott that so-called cure.
Correct.
You have to take that so-called cure. When you watch videos in certain states and so forth, they're starting to force the so-called cure onto the citizens. They're making statement that the uncured is a threat to the cured.
Yeah, mm. Correct. And we henceforth, right, them gonna worship me on the Lord, and those who don't have that kill shot cure, right, them gonna watch me as a threat to the state, because we're not doing according to them new world order. You understand? We're not going according to them. And they don't do like we already, because we're banging on them 24/7, 365. They don't do like we already. So what them gonna, the kind of thing, the kind of lengths them gonna go to just to come against me and the Lord. But hey, Yabashim Yashai in control of everything.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because reason being, the way I was gonna structure is that the ones who not down for the system, you're gonna be an outcast.
Come.
Because the businesses, they're gonna implement that the businesses don't allow uncured person into their business place. And that is where now, that where we gonna have our trust and hope in Yahweh Shimon Shai and present ourselves as a living sacrifice for the Lord, as being that the Lord is gonna take care of us. Because now is the time we ought to show the Lord, well, hey, we ought to please the Lord in His eyesight.
Correct.
That the Lord could be pleased and say, well, hey, this son of mine was doing my will. Because all are we out here to do the will of the Heavenly Father.
Correct.
Follow after the steps of Yahweh Shai.
And concern we were saying there's no reason on to walk. You're on point. You're on point, because watch concerning like schooling and all too. Watch like UTT, NESC, MIC, UE. You understand? All these schools, what UTT yesterday, last week I believe. It was them turning for them students to take that kill shot cure. And as you brother was saying, time to come that you can't even go to school and finish your education. Mm. You can't even go to school and finish your education. All this whole governmental structure, education, health wise, all them government workers on that is so. Right? So them had to go according to that new world order.
Yeah. You know, First Peter 3:14, it says, but if he suffer for righteousness sake, because we stick into the Lord's laws, this here is we putting righteousness, in front of the world. We choose anyhow, wash him and shine in front of the world. It says, but if he suffer for righteousness' sake, happy are ye, and be not afraid of their terror, neither be troubled. Because if we know that we do the works of the Lord, you know, we ought to trust that. We ought not to be afraid, because everything is in control, and the Lord, Yahweh Shemesh Shai, everything is in His hand. You know, He controls everything, just as Yahweh Shai said unto Pilate, you know, that Pilate though had the power, the Lord, everything, let me just see if I get it picked, you know, book of John 19 and 12, I think. So, like, John 19 and 11 to the point. Yahweh Shai answered, thou couldest have no power at all against me, except it were given thee from above. Therefore, he that delivered me unto thee had the greater sin. Reason being, because Pilate was saying that he had the power in his hand to crucify him. And just as how it's gonna be, that the system when I had the power to jail us, they may think that, but everything is in the power of Yahweh Shemesh Shai. When they carry to up to the judges, we ought not to think what to say, because Yahweh is going to put the words in our mouth. And that is where we put in 100% towards this truth. That is what's going to help us. Second Ezra chapter 16 and verse 76. Let's say, I will start at verse 75. It says, be ye not afraid, neither doubt, for Yahweh Hashem Yahushai is your guide, and the guide of them who kept my commandments and precept, saith the Lord Yahweh. Let not your sins weigh you down, and let not your iniquities lift up themselves. And that is why you keeping diligence in this and making your election sure. You're calling up your election sure by keeping the commandments of the Lord. It's what is love? No, if ye love me, keep my commandments. So that will be showing the Lord that we love him by keeping his commandments. And the precepts. That precepts has meaning keeping this knowledge in our minds daily. You know, when certain times reach and we're gonna be hungry in that time, we ought to look up on the precepts. I think it's Mark 4:4, that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of Yahweh Shemesh Shai mouth. You know, so that is the spirit and mindset we ought to be in. Because just now, the farming of the word is going to actually take place, whereby we wouldn't get an opportunity to make we call an election show. Our temptation coming to try everybody. Soon just now, they're going to require everybody to take that so-called cure. But the one who stand firm for Yahweh Shemesh Shai and endure, those are the ones who the Lord going to actually protect and guide. You know what I mean?
Yeah, so it's concerning to what I was saying earlier on too, right? This is Psalms 27 and verse 14. It says, wait on Yahweh, be of good courage, right? So we know going through that timing. We know we have to focus our mind on Yahweh Shemesh Shai, right? We have to focus our mind on studying on these things that are going on around me, because I won't stand on things that are going on around me. Right, I will start looting, I will start killing, I will start different unknown beasts, right? Let's eat people from left, right, and center, right? So we are the focus on them things. We have fear in the rat of Yahweh Shemesh Shai. Well, Slakia, but I shouldn't say the rat, but I should say the things that the Most High put on the earth to purge out this whole earth, right? We shouldn't have fear in that, we should just be having faith for Yahweh Shemesh Shai that we can be counted as one of the elect. That would say, wait on Yahweh, be of good courage, right? We have to have faith in Yahweh Shemesh Shai. It say, and he shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on Yahweh Shemesh Shai.
man, I will end off with this last scripture here. You know, because hey, you run out of time, you have to pick up in that the snow, call your team, see. You get them all, where you at, you know, from us. Yeah, what do you see here, do we daily, honest, making an honest dollar, no fishing. Yeah. I'll bring this last scripture here to close off, book of Psalms 86, right? And I'll start at verse 7. It says, in the day of my trouble, I will call upon thee, for thou wilt answer me.
And slack, slack, and whatever you are. But first, it's me and all too. These jakes and them will come out of the truth. Them gonna be doing the same thing and all too. Them gonna be calling you about Hashem, your shine name. But what gonna go on the most, as the scripture say, the most I gonna close the ear to them. He gonna be, he gonna knock on it with a seal. Right? As the scripture say, at the end, and say, Lord, Lord, hasn't have I not prophesy and preach in your name?
Yeah. I'm finishing up from the last scripture, the book of Psalms 86 and verse 8. It says, among the gods or powers, there is none like unto thee, O Yahweh Shem and Shai. Neither are there any works like unto thy works. Yeah, because just as back then, the marvelous work, the wondrous work that the Lord did in delivering us out of the captivity of Pharaoh, the Egyptians, and from all these other nations back then, all through the book of Judges, how the Lord did his marvelous work and deliver us out of the captivity. But this year will be the last captivity whereby the Lord himself gonna send Yahweh Shai to redeem his people for this last time. You know, but in order for we ought to be the ones doing the Lord's work to be a part of the ones that is to be redeemed.
Correct.
Out of the 144,000. Because it is just we through faith and hope that we is out of the elect, you know. But everything is in the power of Yahweh Hashem and Shai.
As you were saying earlier on too, we had to make we call an election show. We had to continue pushing all that. You understand? We can't we have no time to stop. Right? There's no time to stop. Right now in the end times and where's go when you running a dash? When you're running a freaking 100-meter dash or whatever you're running. When you long to the end then you're looking at full speed ahead. You understand?
Yeah. Because the scripture say that endure to the end, the same shall be saved. The same shall be saved. The scripture said, blessed is he whom the Lord finds in his own.
So I will
ought to do.
You go real people made that all too. You know this is how it is spiritually and physically and all too. Right? Because watch when you're running a race. And men, you see men air full of speed going in front of everybody. You understand the hot, the flame. And we're going on after in the ending. You understand the die dog to fall off. As I can't say any song. You understand? We're riding to the end. You understand? Hopefully, I'm about to be a shy. We can be counted. Right? And where's going with them? What should happen to brothers right now? You understand? That brothers wasn't weak camp on too. Men fiery like first time, men real fiery. I tell myself, hey, but the brothers are really had the word and the really spirit, boy. But that was only the far point of time as the scriptures see and all too. That was just so far wide. We're going to go on you back into the wickedness again.
Man, well, hey, we're going to cut it with that. I mean, double honors unto the elders of the ministers and apostles. Salutation to all the Achaeans pushing this wood. All praise to Yahweh, Hashem and Shai. Shalom.
Shalom. Why about God to Israel and make a thing, no?